Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zollotech, and this week we've had a bunch of different app releases that I thought we'd talk about, as many seem to like the video from last week, which is a continued series from a few months ago. And so to start off, Apple updated Final Cut Pro Motion Compressor in iMovie. So as you can see, if we go into Photos, I took a screenshot of them on the Mac, we have Final Cut Pro and iMovie, and they all fix the same issue. Final Cut Pro gets updated to 10.6.4, iMovie gets updated to 10.3.4, then Compressor gets updated to 4.6.2, and Motion gets updated to 5.6.2. All of them, as you can see, fix an issue where video frames may be out of order during playback or export. So this is something I actually didn't know. I use Final Cut Pro all the time and Compressor and really haven't seen this issue, but it looks like it fixes it. That would be pretty serious if you had frames out of order. So let me know if you're actually having that issue. With the recent release of iOS 16 Beta 5, we regained the battery percentage. This is something a lot of people have wanted. Unfortunately, it's not available on iPhone XR, 11, 12, mini or 13 mini just yet, and you can turn it on and off in the settings. However, if you really like this design, I know some people don't, if you do like it, there's a new app available for your Mac where you can add a similar design to your Mac toolbar or menu bar. And as you can see here, it's $8.99 after the 14-day free trial, and it says see your device battery levels in the menu bar, and you'll see it's just a little bit different. You can also see it in the touch bar. So it's an updated app with sort of an updated interface to bring it in line with the latest version of iOS. So if you're someone that really likes this, I'll link this in the description if you want to try it out yourself. And again, let me know if you like the battery percentage in the iOS update. I'm not sure I really do, but I'll keep it there for a while since it's something that's new. Now, unrelated to an app, but related to testing iOS betas, is Beta Profiles was apparently taken down as violating Apple's terms of service. If you go to Beta Profiles, the website won't load, and on Twitter, the Beta Profiles account says, "Hi everyone, I just wanted to say that Beta Profiles will be shutting down soon. I just don't want to get into legal battles with Apple." So it looks like something they're shutting down. I thought they actually had shut them down quite some time ago. I had heard about that, but apparently they haven't. So basically what that means is in order to get the beta, you'll need to be a beta tester at beta.apple.com or a developer and sign up for a developer account at developer.apple.com. So you'll no longer be able to get it through that website. Let me know what you think about that in the comments below. Now to go along with Twitter, Twitter was updated last week to fix app crashing on Mac. However, many people pointed out that the app icon I was using was not the traditional blue icon, but rather a black Twitter icon, and that's because of Twitter Blue. Last week I mentioned that Twitter Blue had a price increase from $2.99 to $4.99, and it allows you to do other things other than change the app icon, but I just didn't think it was worth it, so I decided to cancel it. So that's why it's blue, and so I thought I'd point that out. So maybe it'll reduce the price again. If they do, then those features may be worth it, but not for $5 a month for me. Now, one of my favorite apps has been updated, and that's 1Password. You'll see we have 1Password 7. Now they've updated it with an all-new 1Password 8. 1Password 8 is a complete redesign with a lot of new features. You'll see it's a completely separate app, and yes, you have Keychain built into iOS, but I really like 1Password, and I've been using it for years because it allows me to use it across multiple platforms and include even more information more concisely, at least in the way that I use it. So you can use it on iOS, iPadOS, macOS, Windows, Android, and so it makes it really nice. But it is an all-new app, so you'll have to actually install the separate one. If we go into it, you can see what's new, and it says redesigned from the ground up. Now, this is not a sponsored video by them, but I will put a link so you can get a discount in the description if you want to check it out. You can try it free for 14 days and then check it out with the paid subscription with a discount. But you'll see it's a modern design, customizable home screen, watchtower dashboard. That's sort of a protection against where it may have been leaked as far as your passwords, biometric unlock, and they've enhanced performance as well. This is completely redesigned here and on Mac as well, and so definitely check it out. If you use password managers, it's at least worth trying out. It's something I use all the time, so again, I'll link that in the description if you want to try it. If not, let me know what you use for your passwords in the comments below. Now, if you're someone that uses Disney Plus unfortunately seems to be getting a price increase in the United States from $7.99 to $10.99 if you want to continue watching Disney Plus without ads. However, they're keeping the original $7.99 price, but with ads inside of it. So that's supposed to take place fairly soon. Unfortunately, they're bumping the price. We're seeing that a lot across many different apps and different services. So I may have to bump that up. I'm not sure yet. We'll have to see how much my family actually uses it. Now, if you're someone that uses Snapchat, that's kind of a big update if you're a parent. And within privacy controls and settings, go to Family Center, and this is an all new section. You'll see it says, "Welcome to Family Center, view your teen's friends." So encourage your teen to only add people they know, use Family Center to see who they're friends with. You can also see who they've messaged, get a glimpse into who they've messaged in the last 7 days, and then you can also report abuse. It says, "Help your teen feel comfortable reporting safety concerns and confidentiality report accounts that you think may have violated our rules." Now, you cannot see messages or what was contained within them, but you can actually see who they've messaged, just to make sure that they're not talking to people that might be trying to scam them or trying to cause them harm. So let me know what you think about this. I'm not someone that uses Snapchat regularly, but I think it's a nice feature that allows you to see some of this, although some people like to just go onto the devices of their children to check them out. Let me know what you think of that in the comments below. Now, if you're someone that maybe uses Reddit, but you don't want to necessarily go into the Reddit app, you get a link from someone, it opens up in Safari. There's a new extension that helps you not get that annoying pop-up that says you need to take a look at this within Reddit or a different app. That's something that's new, and it's called Banish. So you can see here under the App Store, it says Banish for Safari. It says remove annoying open in app pop-ups that block the page. So oftentimes, if you're trying to go into Reddit, as you can see here, you can go from this to this, where it just opens in Reddit like normal on the website. So if you're someone that sees this often, I actually see this a lot, although I do use some Reddit apps, you'll see it will stop this from popping up and make it think you have the app installed and just let you see it overall or bypass this in general. So this seemed to be very helpful. I thought I'd share it with you. Although it is a paid app, it's $1.99, it will block those from popping up. Now, I know a lot of viewers that watch my channel use WhatsApp around the world. While it's not widely used in the United States, most people use iMessage or just text messaging or some other app, WhatsApp is getting some nice features, so I thought I'd share. The first one has to do with deleting messages. So you'll see they tweeted, "WhatsApp said rethinking your message. Now you'll have a little over 2 days to delete your messages from your chats after you hit send." So that's a nice update, where on the iPhone with iMessage, you only get about 15 minutes or 2 minutes really to undo send. Now you'll have 2 days on WhatsApp. So that's something that's new. And then also Mark Zuckerberg said there's 3 new privacy features that were announced on Tuesday and are coming very soon. They actually show this here on Twitter, and it will allow you to exit group chats without notifying everyone, control who can see when you're online, and also prevent screenshots on view once messages. So you'll see screenshot blocking for view once. So this is something they're updating. Hopefully you'll see that very soon. And if you're already seeing it, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Telegram. I actually have a Telegram channel where a lot of people talk about different Apple things. It's linked in the description. It's the official Zollotech Telegram channel. There's a lot of different spam comments. None of those are real. This is the only one. So again, it's linked in the description. This is a legitimate one. And the next version of Telegram is apparently going to revolutionize the way people express themselves in messages, according to the CEO of Telegram, Durov. However, he has said that they're awaiting approval for Apple to release it or review it in the App Store. He said it's been in review for up to 2 weeks and they haven't been able to release it because of that. So hopefully Apple approves that soon. There's been some issues with them, but we should see some major updates there. So if you use Telegram full time or maybe even Signal, let me know what your preferred messaging app is, but Telegram seems to be catching on a lot for a lot of people. Now this week, Spotify is getting a redesign or getting a redesign fairly soon. Soon they're going to launch a new home experience that includes feeds for both music and podcasts and shows. I talked a little bit about this before, but Spotify will get a redesign a little bit where it has more information about all of your different favorite shows, music, and different podcasts all in one. So this should be redesigned soon. I'm not sure the actual date on it, as they haven't said, but it should be fairly soon. Also, last week I talked about how VMware Fusion was updated for M1 Silicon Macs. Now Also, Parallels has been updated with even additional features. So Parallels is another option if you want to run maybe Windows on an M1 Mac or an Apple Silicon Mac, and it makes installing Windows 11 simpler and easier this time around. Also, it supports ProMotion displays. It supports the M1 Ultra, so if you have a Mac Studio with an M1 Ultra, and it also has better IT management options. So that's a great option. If you don't want to use VMware Fusion, you can use Parallels now. Now, if you use HBO Max, that's been updated with some major features. So I subscribe to it on and off if there's shows or movies I want to watch, but it's been updated to support SharePlay on iOS, iPadOS, Mac, and Apple TV. There's also a redesigned interface. So not only does it allow SharePlay, but there's a shuffle button feature that actually expands to mobile devices. Also, there's an enhanced screen reader experience with improved navigation elements and functionality, an intuitive navigation design, according to them, and a redesigned or refined visual style to let content shine. So they've had a major redesign. We also have been seeing this with Amazon Prime on Apple TV. So it's nice to see them make these a little bit better to navigate as sort of content competition heats up between things like Disney Plus, HBO Max, Apple TV Plus, and more. Now, finally, if we go into the App Store, I talked a little bit about where Apple was removing games from Apple Arcade before, and then also they're going to have different advertisements in the Today view. So we'll have more information where maybe an app can advertise here. However, under the Arcade section, if we scroll down, we have a Coming Soon section with expected dates. So we have My Talking Tom. So I don't know if you've used that, but that's kind of an old app that we haven't seen in a while, and it's expected August 12th. So a new version of that. We also have Jetpack Joyride 2 coming soon on August 19th. So that's something I'm looking forward to. I liked the first one a long time ago. And then also Love You to Bits on August 26th. So all of these look pretty good. I think they're getting some better games in Apple Arcade. And of course, I'm open to any suggestion you have about the best games that are new to try out. There's a bunch of them, of course, Sonic Dash and different things. So I want to try out some new games. I don't really play on here, but I do use the iPad a lot for that. So let me know if you have any good sim games or anything like that. Typically on a computer, I play Cities Skylines, Call of Duty, and things like that. Now, if there's any other apps you've heard of that have been updated that I didn't mention, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.